So the coronavirus panic is officially upon us, and if you're new to this game of grab the toilet paper, please be advised that the rules for this pandemic have changed. Why? Well, because Trump is in the White House, so the left has decided that it's all his fault. Because after all, people are dying, it's an election year, and one should never let a good crisis go to waste. Faced with a deadly illness known to target the sick and the elderly, liberals are busy playing their favorite game of Bash the Bigot. In episode 427 of Everyone's a Racist, they're now accusing Trump, his administration, and Republican lawmakers of racism for calling the coronavirus the Wuhan virus and pointing out that it originated in China.
It's going to come across to a lot of Americans as smacking of xenophobia, right, to use that kind of term in this speech, Chris.
And she is demanding an apology for him referring to the virus in very derogatory, offensive terms, calling it the Chinese coronavirus.
However, you have seen on social media, there are hashtags going around that sort of imply, some of them are absolutely racist, some of them imply that this is a Chinese thing, some of them imply that it's connected to Trump.
Well, the President of the United States called it that today. Right.
Never mind that liberals were all too happy to use terms like Ebola, Lyme disease, West Nile virus, SARS, MERS, Rocky Mountain spotted fever, all illnesses named after where they came from. And see, that was perfectly fine for years. But now suddenly the Trump administration is racist for mentioning that this virus came from China. Weird how that's suddenly a problem. Kind of like how the stock market didn't matter till it started tanking. Have you noticed that? Nobody in the news talked about how great the stock market was doing before this. For months, the Dow was clocking in record highs and people's 401ks and investment accounts were booming. And it barely made a headline until it got hit. Now, media hacks who didn't care when it was doing great are falling all over themselves to report on it, which of course only incites more mass panic. Trump didn't get a lick of credit when stocks were climbing into the stratosphere, but they are happy to pin all the blame on him when it gets hit by the flu.
We're watching the Dow again. There you see plummeting after the president's travel ban and coronavirus outbreak announcements.
Right now, the economic fallout from the coronavirus pandemic, it's accelerating around the globe. Here in this country, just minutes after opening, Wall Street had to trigger that so-called circuit breaker once again, pausing trading to prevent a total meltdown. The Dow, as you can see, down more than 2,000 points.
So naming a virus after its place of origin was perfectly normal before, but now suddenly it's racist because Trump said it. The stock market doesn't matter until it tanks because now they can blame Trump for it. H1N1, SARS, Ebola, none of those deadly diseases caused an all-out national heart attack, but now the coronavirus, which is arguably less deadly, is cause for a global shutdown and mass panic. Weird how these rules have changed. Ah, but the solutions are as predictable as ever. See, conveniently, this bug has become a nice scapegoat for peddling all the left's political platforms, like expanding Medicare for all, forgiving student loans, mandating paid sick leave, and dumping more money into already bloated government programs. Crazy how our collective salvation from this apocalypse lies in doing all the things that Democrats wanted to do all along.
Never waste a good crisis.
Especially during an election year when the economy is booming and it's awfully hard to convince people to vote for socialism. Now, don't misunderstand me. There's an incredibly serious component to this virus, especially for our elderly and those with pre-existing conditions. This thing is no joke. But there's also a political aspect here, and it's being exploited with malice and forethought. Either all these liberal talking heads are so gullible as to believe the government can and should completely protect the entire populace from the flu, or they're using a very real, deadly disease as a convenient political football to trash a president they don't like. Guess which camp I think they fall into. And that's your reality check, America. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube page, like us on Facebook and Twitter, wash your hands, and stay sane out there.